things to tend to, so get on with it. If you aim to rob me, I promise it won't end well for you.
Something with me, do you?
Can't talk now.
Here he is! Kill him! double action revolvers and a shotgun? That's plenty.
Pump action and two double revolvers? That's pretty good.
After going to Best Buy and buying a PS4 Pro, God of War, and a big old 4K TV, my boyfriend looked at the PlayStation store like... He could finally experience Horizon Zero Dawn, Uncharted 4,
I think you have any problems with somebody else.
Bloodborne, and Star Fox and Rob. But there was one game he'd been waiting 5 years to play. A game so legendary that it was able to win all of these awards in the same year that GTA 5, Bioshock Infinite, and Tomb Raider came out. Not to mention Aliens Colonial Marines. From the studio that brought you Keith the Thief and Way of the Warrior, The Last of Us, our most requested game by far. It can't be forgotten. But this isn't the 10,000th review of The Last of Us. This is a review of what it's like to live with someone who played The Last of Us twice. Major spoilers ahead, y'all. We got some big spoilers coming. When he first described The Last of Us as a post-apocalyptic third person,
I just can't afford to keep my eyes on you every time you visit. Turn me today, will you?
Still watch while I rolled my eyes. That mashup of genres sounds like everything girlfriends dislike about gaming: loud, gross, and indistinguishable.
Good. Ain't no trace of rust on that, as far as I can see.
Naughty Dog, if you're watching, we don't do potty mouth on this channel, but I'm honoring The Last of Us with my first ever. Holy f- award. I mean, just
you keep treating that like your own child, alright? Good on you.
I love the characters immediately.
I think it's stuck.
What? No. Ha ha. And felt the actual panic of society as my boyfriend moved through the chaos. Normally, main characters in video games, and almost always children, make it out alive.
It's only 90%.
But this guy must have had plot armor piercing ammo, because your daughter died. Even my boyfriend was like, holy f-, and I was pretty much this.
Come on now, boy.
But when he asked me if I wanted him to keep playing, I was like, because that was dope. Not the dead game specifically, but like, The Last of Us feels like it was made for backseat gamers.
Well, better than nothing.
It has a linear story told in easily consumable chapters, which is becoming rare in the industry. As much as I like the plot in most open world games, my boyfriend usually goes, oh, the main story's over there? I'm gonna go the exact opposite direction and do fetch quests.
Yeah, you're fine, man.
And then all the urgency is lost, I forget who people are and what he was even supposed to be doing. But in The Last of Us, the plot is omnipresent. It's in the environment. Who's with them? Rooms over every violent encounter. Plays out in dialogue while you explore.
Picks me up like a guitar.
And then shines in the best performance.
What'd you forget to do last time?
Uh-oh, mister. You be careful there, partner. You seem a little tipsy.
Don't tell me that I would be safer with someone else, because the truth is I would just...
Hello, mister.
The cutscenes and acting in this game...
Got any idea what time
zombie
it is?
Don't act.
Wouldn't know.
No problem. Take care now.
The story-driven gameplay is what makes the third-person stealth cover zombie shooting actually enjoyable to watch.
Ah!
recognize you.
God damn it.
Time to get out of here. Time to get out of here. Time to run.
Next time.
Guy who's a beefcake.